A little disclaimer, I'm not writing actual physics. This is game dev pseudo-physics. So let me show you the jump. You can jump straight up or jump forward, up forward. And you can see that the player at the bottom is sort of sliding out. This is what I observed in Street Fighter 2. And the key point here is, instead of just making linear interpolations, I have easing functions. If you don't know what easing means, usually in game dev it means these things. So instead of the values changing in a linear fashion, here's an example. You can see the dot moving in many different ways with all these examples. This is called easings.net. You can go check it out. I have all the links below. I've seen a lot of Unity users just do linear interpolation, which is kind of boring. We might also have the bouncing here. Elastic. This might be good for UI movement. So for now, for most of the stuff, I'm using sine operation. Let me show you the dot again. So as you jump up, the initial force is the strongest, and as you peak, as you reach your peak, you slow down. For falling, it's the opposite. After you lose all your momentum going up, you slowly start going down, and as you move further down, you accelerate. Kind of like physics, pseudo physics. Another area where I applied the sine operation or easing is the camera movement. You can barely see it, but I've automated the camera zooming in and out, as well as the movement. If I move the players, you can see that the camera is focusing, not focusing, but centered in between the two players. So at all times, no matter where they are, you can see both of the players. And the movement and the zooming in and out is supposed to be based on sine operations, but it's kind of hard to see with the camera, but it's there. Another important factor is collision resolve, meaning what do you do when these two yellow boxes that represent player boxes, what do you do when the yellow boxes overlap with each other? The answer is you simply resolve it, as in move. In this case, you move the boxes in the opposite directions based on where they're coming from. So at no point these two boxes are coexisting in the same place. Maybe for a brief second, but I'm resolving them as soon as possible. If you've played Street Fighter 2, you might also notice that the player at the bottom, when there's collision between a player that's in the air and a player that's on the ground, you might have noticed that the player on the ground is moving out faster, is being resolved faster than the player that's in the air. It's kind of hard to notice it here, but the rate at which the bottom player is slipping out is double the speed compared to the player at the top. If both of them are on the ground, you see equal force. So if I try to move into each other, you can see that the forces nullify each other. For more details regarding collisions, as well as other stuff regarding the OLC Pixel Game Engine, which is what I'm using right now, I recommend checking out Mongo Encoder. Again, all the links are below. That's it for this video. If there are any questions, you can reach me on my Discord server. Thanks for watching. See you next time.